You know, just another request on the channel, but from a good friend, Bo Sheen. I'd like to thank Bo for this very cerebral request, because this guy was a very cerebral player. Now, there was anticipation that once he made the NHL, he was going to make a big stink against the bigger teams, because he knew we were going to be drafted by some of the second division of the league. And when Minnesota took him, just like that, the fortunes of the North Stars turned around. Within 2 years of being drafted, he helped defeat the Habs, stopping their four Stanley Cup run in 1980. Got to the Stanley Cup Finals against the Islanders. Like Lou Nanny once said, one of the biggest Minnesota coaches ever and official with the team, he was one of the most clutch players of his generation. Now, he didn't play that long because injuries and other factors, again, limited him. But when Steve Payne took the ice, everybody had a watch. Now, he first came to Major Province with Don Mills of the MTJHL. Now, the native of Scarborough, born in Toronto, played in the OMJHL with Ottawa for 2 years before being drafted. Now, the left winger was a solid 6'2", 205. He had 47 points in 77 and 94 points in only 52 games in 78. Now, entering the 78 amateur draft, he was ranked the number 19 overall prospect, and of course, he was taken 19 overall. Now, he played in the line with future teammate Bobby Smith and Tim Higgins for Ottawa in 78. Now, he also missed part of the 78 season with a broken right hand. He had also had 2 5-goal games for Ottawa in 78, and he was voted the OMJHL's most underrated player for 78. Now, we're talking about cerebral. He took biology classes at Carleton University during his junior career to improve his overall scholastic ability. Now, first came to Major Province in the NHL with a big game in 1978 against their future opponents, the Montreal Canadiens. Now, he eventually retired December 27th, 87 with 228 goals, 238 assists for 464 points. But he really, really opened out in the playoffs, ladies and gentlemen. 70 points in 71 games, including 35 goals. Again, made the All-Star game in 1980-85 for Minnesota. Played for Team Canada in the 79 World Championships and 81 Canada Cup. And that year, of course, in 81, he lost against the Islanders of Minnesota that year. He was Minnesota's 3-star award winner for 85, the KSTP Radio Trophy for Most Improved 1980, and he holds the record for most points in one playoff year, co-hold in 81 with 29. He had 17 goals in 81 and most goals in one playoff series against Boston 81 with 7. Now, he also had 5 consecutive playoff games where he won at least one goal in 81 with 5. Now, he led the NHL playoffs in goals with 17 in 81. He was Minnesota's goal leader in 80, 81, and 85. Their points leader in 81 and 82, and their playoff goals leader in 80, 81, and 82. Also the assist leader as well. The big line he played on, which devastated Montreal in the playoffs, was that big two-way line with Bobby Smith and Al McAdam in the 79 and 80 season. He said Minnesota and Dallas single-season records is broken for points and goals in 1980 by a left wing. He scored a series-winning goal to overtime goal for Minnesota in Game 7 of the team's North Division Final versus St. Louis. Now, injuries really hurt him. He had a bad cervical disc problem in the 85-86 season, which put him out for a couple of months. Then a right knee injury. He also missed part of 87 with an injured right knee, and all missed part of 88 with a pulled abdominal muscle. Now, he also missed the end of the 87 season with a knee injury suffered during a March 14 game in Detroit. Then a neck injury after being hit from behind on November 14, 87 in Washington. The injury caused bone spurs to develop, and these spurs grew into his spinal cord. Payne played his last game on December 5th, 87 in Calgary before doctors determined if he continued playing, he would need career-ending spinal fusion surgery to repair the problem in his neck. He retired rather than risk future damage. He ended his career again with the Minnesota-Dallas record for goals by a left wing, which has since been broken, with 228 and playoff goals with 35. Now, he also played a little bit in the CHL-IHL as part of his recovery process. Second place in the Canada Cup, and it was a reserve there, did not play. And in the 79 Worlds, of course, a tough result, fourth place for Canada. Now, He also played on the Minnesota team that competed in Sweden's 1980 DN Cup tournament. Now, he was also a drag racing fan and invested in the sport during his playing days. He also was named left wing on an all-time Ottawa 67s team by a CHL panel in 99. Now, very, very diverse individual. Now, a longtime supporter of the U.S. military, despite being born in Canada, big on the veterans. He sits on the advisory board of the United Heroes League, a nonprofit that helps children of active military families participate in hockey, baseball, football, and basketball. He's also the director of the UHL Outdoors Program that takes military parents and their children fishing with sports celebrities from the NHL, NFL, and MLB at various locations around North America. Now, he's also supported the nonprofit Project Healing Waters Fly Fishing as the founder and director of the Battle of Boxwood, a fundraising fly fishing event which was held from 2011 to 2018 at the Boxwood Gulch Ranch near Shawnee, Colorado. The event featured 20 recovering military members fishing with celebrities from the NHL, NFL, and music industry, and was featured on the outdoor TV series Fly Rod Chronicles and Sportsman 360, as well as a special feature Embracing Our Troops. Now, Payne and his wife live in rural Wisconsin, and you have two adult children. So again, quite a career, and quite a legacy, because Steve can best be described is sort of like a junior Mike Bossy. When a puck needed to go in, it went in. Now, the big seasons, and he had seven of them, back-to-back from 79 to 85, 23-42, 30-33-30, 28-29. Now, what he's really known for, in 34 playoff games, which included contests against some really big clubs, 43 points in 34 games and 80 and 81, 24 goals, 19 assists. And like I said, every goal, like Lou Nanny said, every goal he scored was big. Now, in 1980, that's the closest he got to 50 goals. I think the biggest regret that I saw is that he never scored 50. He was always getting that big 28 to 35 goal pace. But 1980, everything seemed to be right, but unfortunately he couldn't get it. But listen, Steve Payne, I saw him playing the forum. I said to myself, this guy's another Steve Shutt. I mean, you give him a chance, the puck's in a net, or he's setting up something else. Smooth skater, and not to say he was a power forward, but pretty friggin' close. But ladies and gentlemen, what an honor to watch the old Minnesota North Stars, because, you know, it took a great team in 1980 to knock off the Habs, and Steve was part, again, one of the most underrated NHL teams of the early 80s. Any team like, you wouldn't take any team with Bobby Smith and Al McAdam and Steve Payne would be underrated, but their feud against Boston that era too, it's quite interesting, you should look it up. Boston and Minnesota did not get along, ladies and gentlemen. A true rivalry. Thanks for listening. Bye.